So what I am going to do, I am going to log this data and I am going to log this output data. Okay. So what we are going to do it, we are going to save this input and output, and we are going to create a mathematical equation for that. Transfer function for that. Okay. When I run this, and when I open this data inspector, so you see this is the input and this is the output. We are going to use this input and output of this nonlinear system to create a transfer function. So I am going to save this data, export this data, okay, and let me give me a file name as a x1, export it. And second, I am going to export this output also here. That file name will be as a x2. It is exported in Simulink, in Workspace. This is my x1, this is my x1, and this is my x2. It is in a form of time series data. So from x1 dot time, to create a transfer function, we require a sampling time as well. So this is the time which is showing you. If I do a diff of it, if I take a difference of this time step, it will tell me the step time. What is the step time? It is around 4, right? The step time is 4. The step time we require input and output. So I am going to save my input here, x1 dot. Okay, just wait a minute. x1 dot data, okay. I am going to save this input as a x1. So this is my input, and again from x2 I am going to save it my x2. Now we have a sampling step time, we have a input, we have a output. We are going to create a transfer function for that. So what we can do, we can go in app, we can go here in control system, and there is a option, system identification toolbar. It is a part of a system identification. We can use this tool to create a transfer function. So like this, whatever model you have in Simulink, just save the input and output, and you can use that to create a transfer function. Basically, transfer function is output by input. So here we are going to import that data. That is a time domain data. Input is x1. Output is x2, and sampling time is 0.4. Import this. So here is my data which is imported right now. Okay. Now further, if you want to do some kind of pre-processing to removing noise or means, you can use this. But in my case, I am going to create a transfer function. So you can create a state space model as well. Polynomial equations as well. I am going to choose transfer function in my case. Okay. And here you can provide how many number of poles do you want and how many number of zeros do you want. So in my case, I am using 4 poles and 1 0, and I am going to estimate it. So it will create a transfer function for me. And result will be displayed here. So you can see here, estimation data is 95.46%. It's perfect. Accuracy is 95%. And the transfer function, if you want to see it, you can check it from here. This is the transfer function which is generated from. So any kind of time series data, if you have from any kind of system, if it is linear, then you can create a transfer function like this. So this is a transfer function. To check this with the original one, that the output I am getting or not, already I created one model here in the same data, same model which we had here. So here what I am doing it, this one was original model, and this is a transfer function of the system which we created it. Let's run it and compare that what the output is coming. So you can see here, the yellow one was original model, and the blue one is from the transfer function. Okay, so almost it is same. My system was non-linear, we linearize the whole system. We created a transfer function for that.